this is Mila. She's a very petite little seal point female. She's about, I'd say, somewhere between 3 and 4 years old, but we'll know more when she goes to the vet on Monday. She was picked up in a very rural area of Virginia and brought into a high kill shelter. And a very caring group in that area pulled her out of there when her time was up to keep her from being put to sleep, because they don't have much adoption exposure at this shelter. And she was kept with a foster that was, I would say, just a bit overwhelmed between her job and a lot of other cats that they've done the same thing for to keep them from being put to sleep. And she's a bit on the shy side. She has not had a lot of one-on-one attention, which I'm working with her now. Today is the first day that I've uncovered the bottom of her cage, and up until about 2 minutes ago, before I put her back into this bed, she's been hiding behind it. She's very cooperative. She likes to be petted, as you can see. Look at her. She's making bread in her little soft bed. She loves the billy bed. She loves to be petted. I got her on Wednesday, and today is Saturday, and she wasn't eating. But after putting some of the tasty food, I actually stuck it in her mouth with my finger. I convinced her that the food is good. Now she's eating, thank goodness. She does have good litter box habits. She hasn't eaten enough to give me any poop yet in her litter box, but she does use a litter box for her pee. And I would think by the end of today, her little belly will have enough in there that she can produce some poop. But she's just a very sweet little girl. Now, she does have a hernia, and it is reducible. And I am taking, again, I told her I'm going to take her into the vet on Monday, and we're going to see about getting that hernia operation, her hernia repaired. She's already spayed, and it won't be too long before she'll be ready to go, but I do want to work with her a little bit and make sure that she's becomes a little more confident. And that's just going to come with me just spending time with her. Once her isolation time is up and her little belly is healed, I can let her out in the room with other cats and see how she does. And I will dog test her. But for now, we're just going to let her chill. Today is 23rd, I think. I am going to put her on Adopt Me, but I just wanted you to know ahead of time what's coming for her. I still don't know a whole lot about her because she's been hiding, but everything I do know so far, I've just told you. She's very soft, and lots of times she'll leave her little tongue sticking out. She's just a cute little thing. She does talk to me. Mila, want to talk to me, Mila? Hey, sweet girl. Look at her. She's beautiful. I'm going to try and get some of these stills, too. Hey, sweetie. Let's get up close and see if you can see her beautiful blue eyes. Hey, sweetie. Mila. What do you hear? She hears one of my cats coming down the stairs, upstairs. Oh, and I have a cat on the other side of the room. She saw her moving. So I guess she wanted to see what she's doing. Hey there, sweetheart. Hey there, little girl. Mila, you want to talk to me? She's a petite little girl. She weighs about 7 pounds. Because now she's probably down a little bit from not eating for a couple of days. But yesterday morning, I finally got her to eat something, and she ate. She did good last night, and she ate this morning. I didn't have to even put it in her mouth this morning. I just had to shove it under her nose. The next step will be to convince her to get up on the shelf, which she had been doing, because I've noticed she is starting to get into her dry food, and she is drinking water. So I think she must get up on the shelf at night when it's quiet and dark in here. During the day, I have the radio on. And up until this morning, I had another cat in the room. He went home this morning. But he used to hiss and growl at her, and that's why I had the bottom of her cage covered. He didn't like other cats. Hey. But she's a beautiful little girl. I think she's going to do, she'll make somebody a really nice cat once I try and get her over the shyness a bit. Some cats never really get over that, and it just takes them a while to bond with their person. And though I want her to trust me, I really don't want her bonding with me because it just makes it harder when they go home. So I'll do what I have to do to make her comfortable, and then the adopter can work on the bonding process. My goal is just so that she will trust me and not hide all the time when I come down. And I think that's just going to be a matter of her getting used to her environment. She's a good girl, though. Let's see, she's not trying to hide from me now, and I'm making a lot of noise. I always talk to her, and when I come in the room, I call her, and I say, "Hey, Mila, what you doing?" So she's getting used to my voice, which I know, as I've been told, is kind of gravelly, but that's my little girl. There you go.